Also tonight, a surge in the recycling of electronic waste. E-waste companies say the amount recycled has gone up by at least 50% from 3 years ago. And they expect this to increase even further, partially driven by the increasing amount of e-waste being generated.
Tech-savvy Yu Jie is a heavy gadget user. He changes out the batteries every 1.5 years to maintain the lifespan of each device.
I know a lot of people, but once their phone battery is getting low, then they'll just change the entire phone, right? But for me, I don't like to think that way. I'm like, the phone still works fine, everything still works fine, why do I want to buy a new one? But it's much cheaper to change the battery.
One local e-waste company says it has seen recycling of consumer electronics rise by 40% since 2021, thanks to this sort of user behaviour. Rapid tech advances also mean buyers switch to new models more frequently. It's seeing a similar pattern in corporate recycling.
I expect e-waste from businesses to increase, especially with the rise of AI systems. Regular hardware upgrades or replacements will likely be more common as companies update or replace devices. Part of these upgrades might be used in less advanced systems or recycled to recover materials like metals.
Another e-waste firm has been able to recycle more of each item it collects. 95% of materials can now find new life, up from 80% 3 years ago.
A lot of manufacturers that are manufacturing electronic products are also going into the sustainable pathway and introducing the new kind of packaging, recycled products, recycled material into the circular economy.
Mr. Xia says this is another reason why he expects recycling volumes to rise further.
Not sure what goes into that recycling bin at home? Well, you can now just ask a chatbot on Telegram or WhatsApp. The National Environment Agency hopes the new Bluebin AI chatbot will help cut the amount of food, liquids and other contaminants that find their way into recycling bins and cut the rate of non-recyclables, which has remained at 40% since 2018. Eugene Chow with more.
Students and staff at Unity Primary School bring in about 100 kilograms of recyclables every week. With that much paper, plastic and metal collected, the school wants to make sure none of it's wasted. So it continues to educate everyone. For instance, drink cans must be clean and dry, otherwise they cannot be recycled and might as well be thrown away.
In school, I learned that even the smallest actions can make the biggest impacts. And it has also made me more aware of my habits at home. For example, now I have learned the importance of educating my family members on how to recycle right.
What we hope to do is that through all these educative efforts, our students are able to spread the message of recycling and the importance of conservation and hopefully be ambassadors to the community so that more will participate in recycling.
For those who aren't in school, a new chatbot on Telegram and WhatsApp can help instead. Users can send a question or picture to check if an item can be recycled.
We hope that this will help us raise the current domestic recycling rate of 12% to reach our target of 30% by year 2030. Because among the things we recovered in our blue bins, we still have about 40% of items that are contaminated. So we really need the public to help us to rinse their plastic bottles, etc., so that the things are clean when they deposit into the blue bin and do not contaminate the other items.
The Bluebin AI chatbot can be found on the Clean and Green Singapore website.
Let's dig a little deeper into the story on e-waste recycling with Vincent Quek. He is a sustainability and e-waste consultant at Viral Green Singapore, a provider of electronic asset disposal and recycling services. Vincent, welcome to the program. Tell us, how quickly are people changing their devices and how do we prevent more of those devices from going to the landfill?
I think that people are changing the devices at a quicker rate due to, you know, the urbanizations, the affluent populations that we have. So coming back to your question is that, you know, how come people are changing into that is because technology is getting better and faster. And because of this, right, it also increase the disposal rate.
How do we control these devices then from going to the landfill?
Okay, to control this thing, actually we have in place is the Producer Responsibility Scheme, PRS, where the operator has already in place a lot of like e-waste receptacles, bins around the communities. So if let's say your devices are obsolete and you want to, you do not throw the things away, you recycle the things into a recycle bins in the community.
Okay, and in your experience, how often do ordinary consumers like you and I recycle our e-waste, and what are the challenges that they might be facing?
I think that our challenges, I think that businesses, I talk about businesses, right? Businesses often they recycle e-waste to make it more proper because the recycling is crucial for data security. And many companies are actually mandated to work with established e-waste recycler for proper disposal and with certification. So likely this will actually help them in their higher recycling rate. But if let's say it comes to the consumer, right, many consumers may not understand the environmental consequences of improper e-waste disposal or find it difficult to locate convenient e-waste recycling point. So these are the challenges, you know, definitely to hinder the efforts to promote e-waste recycling.
It is not just about recycling more than, it is also about recycling well. What is the right process to recycle all phones, your laptops and batteries properly?
Okay, not many people aware of e-waste recycling. So it will be lesser on the specific of proper e-waste disposal. So personally, I feel that if let's say your device is still functional, please consider selling or donating it. And it that can give the device a second life or reduce e-waste, which is definitely better than recycling. But if let's say what I just mentioned is not possible, then here are some key steps for recycling e-waste for laptops and handphones. For laptops and handphones, do a factory reset to remove any personal data from the devices to protect privacy. And not to worry, as a e-waste recycler, we handle devices with media storage. And when we handle these items, right, we will apply data standardizations to remove any data that may still inside the device. And yeah, so that is for laptops and handphones. Yep.
Earlier, you talked about Singaporeans not being aware about recycling e-waste. Why is that the situation? And how do we keep Singaporeans more informed about this?
I think that first and foremost is to have more awareness in the community. You know, because a lot of people, when they want to do e-waste recycling, they are not informed of the recycling bin. And they do not know that, you know, if let's say they do not recycle the e-waste and they just put it inside the trash bin or general waste bin, it will add inventory into our Semakau landfill. That's one thing. So it's to create more awareness in the community, within the schools, within the community, within the agency. You know, everyone needs to do their parts to have a proper e-waste recycling initiative or a more effective e-waste recycling initiative.
You know, Vincent, Singapore tends to recycle electronics like old fridges, your laptops and phones to the region where they are remodeled and sold. What do we need to be aware of when doing this form of e-waste recycling?
I think that before the implementation of this PRS, right, Singapore often export old fridges, laptops without storage dividers and reset handphones to other regions. So, of course, with this, it will help the domestic waste burden. It may also pose significant risk, I feel. A major concern is that when the product cannot be refurbished due to whatever reason, and thus increase the potential for illegal dumping in countries with weaker environmental regulation. So when these items are exposed to rain, heavy metals from this product can leach into the drainage system, contaminating the waterway and thus posing health risks for the communities.
Vincent, thank you very much for speaking with us tonight. That was Vincent Quek, Sustainability and E-Waste Consultant at Viral Green Singapore.